Now would you like me to be the cat?
Well, like, and I said to him, I went, what happened to Catman? He went, he fucking hung himself.
What's happening? Welcome back, Pretendship, episode 98. Thanks for waiting for this little special episode we got here. You've already seen who we've got in the treehouse today. It is two of my favourite humans. Two fan favourite guests as well. No, refuse to acknowledge it, either of you.
I won't go that far.
There's been public outcry, demand. Come back on. That's what my mum said. She texted me.
Really?
She didn't.
No, she didn't. My mum actually says when she watches Zach ones, she's like, I watched it for about 10 minutes and then he started talking about, you know, dry bumming girls with a sock on his knob and I had to turn it off.
She still won't accept my friends request on Facebook from 3 years ago.
Oh, really? Yeah, by the way. Oh,
go around, knock on the door. You're like, what the fuck's going on?
In case you haven't clocked on yet and you're just listening or something, it's Zachariah O'Higgins and Cal O'Neill.
Yeah, he's got gonorrhea on his tongue.
I've got tongue gonorrhea.
He's got tongue gonorrhea.
It might be tongue cancer, you know. Because you know Michael
We can only hope. No.
Please, I'm coming around, mate. No, but like legit, Michael Douglas got tongue cancer.
I think I got throat cancer.
Yeah, like throat or tongue cancer, some shit, same thing, isn't
it? Same shit, isn't it?
Yeah, same shit. And like, apparently, that was like due to or related to like giving oral sex
too many times.
So that Catherine Zeta-Jones birds.
So what you're saying is Catherine Zeta-Jones' pussy is fucking filthy.
It is cancerous.
Is that your excuse then when girls want mutting out and you're just like, look, babe, you're going to have to do me, but then I don't want cancer, so you get yourself off?
Yeah.
Yeah. Motion pass. Yeah.
Yeah.
I vote for that.
We're all girlfriended up in here, aren't we?
Yeah. We've all got girlfriends.
Yeah, so you can stop inboxing us all.
Fucking put your fannies away, you little tarts.
I hope that they stop inboxing.
It's just too much.
I don't think I've ever once received any sort of flattering DM from anyone. No. And I'm glad.
So full of shit.
That's true. I would tell, man, I'd be sending you screenshots. Look at this thirsty.
This fucking guy, man.
I'm glad though, because.
Like the fittest guy I know. Like, all the birds are like, Pete, you're so interested in creative.
Some dinner lady from Hagfold, if she was just like, I'd love spots
all
on
the
your
girls
face.
I know fancy Peter.
Thank you.
We can't, I'm going to have to cut this out, aren't I?
Nah,
it's going to look like I've
in.
Paid you to say
this
it.
This is staying in.
You've not paid us to say this.
When will you pay us?
I always work it from him, like, yeah, I'm like, he's fucking super clever and fucking big old Brian Goldberg knob on him and everything.
Have I been a good wingman to you back in the day or no?
Sometimes, yeah. Sometimes not.
Sometimes not. I think I'm pretty decent with it. I'm like, this is Zach, he's like national boxing champion.
Yeah, like, no, when you need to be, like, you will be, but sometimes just for a fucking laugh, you'll just
sabotage.
Do something fucking
sabotage
dumb.
Sabotage the whole mission.
Because these thirst traps are out there. You see them. You must see them on the internet. On the gram. Do you know what the worst thing is? I don't know if either of you see girls that do this. They sort of establish themselves. They objectify themselves, right? I'm not talking about us perving on girls that aren't asking for it. My eyes are up here.
Whoa, did you just say asking for it?
Ones that are asking for
Whoa.
It.
Whoa. Hashtag me too.
I'm talking about ones where their profile picture is selfies, all tits. They're getting the tits and the ass in one picture with just like, oh my God, save the Afghan refugees. And they've got their titties out.
They're doing it for them, not you. That's for themselves. Right.
Yeah, I would agree with that, except I'm not booting the front door in and going, look at your tits. They're putting it online. They're putting a picture online for comments and shit, right?
Yeah.
But like, anyway.
100%.
I'd prefer it if you were actually kicking doors and going, look
at
your tits.
I actually, literally.
Look at your fucking tits.
I'd empty a full bag on them bad lads. Fuck off. I spoke to a bird the other day and she was just like, yeah, no, girls are full of shit. Like, I literally do that. For attention. I was like, that's cool though, like we all want to feel good.
Yeah. Right. We all understand the
just
game.
Don't bullshit me
we
about
would
it.
All
we all understand what's going
lad,
on.
I went on Tinder a few years ago. We had a little hiatus, me and
it was a break.
She knows about it. And I was literally on there, probably not even trying to meet anyone. I was just like, let's see what kind of, you know, see if anyone wants the peace. You know what I mean?
And did they?
Nobody wanted it.
Bullshit.
That dude.
Bullshit.
I didn't get, like, I got about two matches.
All the gear, no idea, lad. Got his pretty face, fucking Adonis body, big old knob, but can't talk to birds, lad.
It's no game.
But my point was going to be, girls that sort of establish their page as like a page you would go to sort of scroll through, you know, pictures of milk bags. You know what I mean? It's like, it's not even 50-50 pictures of food and, you know, friends and shit. It's just like bang, 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 all the way through. So, you know, like, oh yeah, let's see what titty shot. And you click on the stories and then it's pictures of them with their little niece and their little nephew and shit. I'm like, oh, totally fine if that's your personal account, but it appears to be a feeder account for your fucking OnlyFans profile. So why
just be honest, man, when you see that image, it just ruins your wank.
Why are you laughing? Are you thinking of someone specific?
Well, yeah, it sort of seemed like you was talking about someone specific.
I'm not. There's literally dozens of them out there.
Oh, okay.
Who are you on about?
I'm not going to say.
I don't know. It's down to maybe 4 or 5 girls I think you might be on about, but there's loads of them. And I don't know why they post these other... It's like, be that if you want, but then all the other stuff is wildly inappropriate. Or be the inappropriate, and then what the fuck are you doing? Get that baby out of here.
The last thing I want to see when I've got an erection is a baby.
Yeah, definitely.
Come too quick.
Yeah.
You're just fucking palming that one off like an idiot.
I'm just trying to calculate how many dislikes.
I'm too good to have a
I don't know if YouTube will like allow it, because it gets stricter and stricter, you know.
They listen to what's going on.
They'll run it through an algorithm and it'll transcribe the whole fucking episode, and then they'll look for search terms like babies give me erections, and then do you know what I mean?
Fuck.
I don't even get
erections.
Oh. Fuck am I doing?
Okay, fucking stupid, you.
Get the hood up, man, get the hood up.
I'm fucking talking about.
For people only.
So, anyway, you were talking about baby erections, right?
Yeah, little babies' erections. Babies do get erections, you know. You can get erections. You can get.
They do.
You can get erections in the third trimester inside. While you're still unborn, you can get a little baby erection.
Tell them what they all said when you were first born, when they seen your balls.
What?
This was some adult females.
Yeah, I had big old nads when I was born. But you've seen them now, little pea bollocks now, haven't you?
Peter pea balls.
Don't understand what's going on.
Yeah, it's all them roids you're doing, man.
Zach's the one that's done roids.
Really?
If I wasn't asked about like fucking chucking you under the bus, I'd get a picture up of a before and after of Zach. Because his skull has changed. I don't know if you've gone through giga puberty or what, but you shot up like 3 foot. You're still only like, what, 5'2", 5'6",
all right.
5'8" on Tinder. But you fucking skull changed shape.
Oh, fucking shit, this one.
Your hairline pissed off. Prostitutes, what are we saying?
Depends, am I on holiday or what?
It's all good on holiday.
Yeah, I reckon so. Amsterdam. Why not?
Would you consider prostitute use, sex worker visits, cheating? Would you do it these days now you're cuffed up?
No, I don't want a skank in the flat.
But no, just like out in a... Yeah. In a
oh, bathroom. Right, okay. Nah, I'm all right. They're strange places.
We can edit this bit out.
Yeah, they are weird. Just like, I went in one with Zach.
Morally bankrupt, I would never do it.
Do you remember we've...
Bollocks.
Do you not want to admit that you've been?
I don't give a fuck.
Do you remember we went in Diamonds a couple of times?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Is it called Diamonds?
Diamond Dolls.
Diamond Dolls up on, is it in Cheetah Mill?
Cheetah Mill Road.
And this was a jip, right? We went in there. I always used to just chill. I'll chill while Zach's like in there.
Yeah, yeah.
You remember what I'm like. I'll just like hang out with the other birds. Honestly.
Oh shit, did you turn into like Louis Theroux with
just
all the...
Yeah, definitely, anywhere,
definitely.
Like, but why this life?
Yeah.
And this poor Romanian girl's like...
What did you want to
like,
be?
You've been there a few times when I've been to brothels, to be fair.
Yeah. Dude, one time you were in there and they like took me off into the red room. I think they thought I was like a tough cookie and you know, I was like
playing
hardball, but I was just like, oh, nice. And they were just like, yeah, you could handcuff me up on that wall and stab me. And I was just like, oh, yeah, nice.
So what do you think of the weather recently? Interesting. Or?
But there was one time Zach went in there and there was this scouse bird. Do you remember her?
He was fucking horrible.
And she was just like, oh, one sec, love. I'm just texting my brother. He's just making me tea. And just like chatting about her life and stuff. And Zach's like, yeah.
She's like wanking my flaccid dick off going, oh, I've got a fat fucking spliff and a Sunday dinner when I get home. What a fucking weight. Like. What?
Dude, was it, little dick when she just... eating crisps while she was doing
yeah, it? Yeah, yeah. She was eating crisps while wanking.
She was actually eating some prawn cocktail crisps. What did she say when you walked in the room? She was like, right, I don't kiss and I don't do weird shit.
Pretty much. Stay away from my feet and my ass.
Was that the one where you came out and I was just like, what's that smell? Or was that a different one?
No, it was a different time, that.
Zach came out and I was like, whoa, what the fuck? And he was just like, yeah, I fingered this girl and I don't know, I've never had...
Not a girl, it was a prostitute. She's not a human.
That was bad. Zach's views do not represent the views of the podcast. But yeah, it got in the car. You could literally see it. It was like a film of...
Oh,
it was like
no.
This, like, yellow fucking slime.
You got chlamydia like, all over your hand.
And Zach's driving. What I was the like, fuck? I was like, you're going to have to put your fingers out the window, man.
All the way home, then the fucking East Lang's just out to all my fingers. You could window see, like that.
There was like streaks coming off it, you know, like a cartoon.
Oh, no!
You know, like in a cartoon when there's like a pie and then
he's
the smell.
He's got poison fanny juice on his fucking fingers, man. What the fuck?
It was bad news, man.
You're a hero amongst men. Well done, son.
Would you consider it cheating if a girl went to a male... what do they call them? Male escort? A gigolo? Yeah, yeah. On holiday?
Yeah,
if she was like, look, I have physical needs, but I don't want to get entangled with any, like, actual people.
Yeah, so I'm going to bring you gonorrhea home, kind of thing.
But, yeah, he, like, bags up and stuff.
Oh, okay.
Like currently, like, knowing, like, the relationship I've got now, no, because I'd be like, that's not the agreement we have. If it was
so
like a polyamorous
one. It depends on the agreement that you have.
Yeah, if I had a polyamorous relationship with someone and I'd got my head around it, and whereas now I'm like, oh, we're just like monogamous, that's what it is. Mm-hmm. So I'm just like, that's what we are.
What do you reckon is...
You'd be going fucking ballistic.
Like in a watch.
What do you reckon, like male, because there's a very, you understand, everyone can guess what female sex workers are going to look like, what they're going to do to try and seem most like... sexy on that base level of, you know, they're not trying to like be challenging and stimulating, they're just trying to be like, I'm a sex object. That's what they're trying to do so they can get cash. What a guy's gonna look like, what they're gonna do to be that for girls.
I think there's obviously like a good portion of them who were just like obviously just like personal trainers and like they look mint, but I reckon
is that the main thing, do you reckon, bodied up?
Maybe not, because I a lot of women might, in the red, they might think, oh, that's mint, but they might feel like intimidated
feel
by it.
Yeah.
So they go, oh, I'll go for someone who is like less than them, and then like there's someone normal,
some little pot belly,
and they can have a good time.
Some little pot bellied guy.
So, yeah, is that going to be a popular gigolo style dad bod?
Maybe you'd have to ask, like, girls are probably more secretive about it.
Yeah,
like,
because I
so
bet we know a few girls that have been to one of these guys.
No, because they could just get laid by anybody, nothing below a six.
Man, I can't believe, like, girls do not know how good they've got it. You could go into a club and tell the DJ, can you just cut the music off? Give me that mic. And they could just be like, anyone trying to shag me tonight? And they watch dozens of hands go up and they could just be like, you and you, let's go.
I say this to girls who, like I know, and like, they're like, oh, I just have problems, you know, they're just like, I mean, how do you like? And I'm like, you could be the ugliest girl and have a good chance of fucking the hottest guy you can find just because, like...
That's what
it's
we're,
just how it is. Like, yeah,
we're wired to like,
yeah, like do this. Pieces of
and they
shit.
Say that like girls are less visual than guys, and that guys it's more about like just if you fit or not. Whereas girls need you to be charismatic and funny and interesting, charming, all this other shit. But I think personality goes an equally long way with girls. That there's girls that I think are sexy, but then you go, wait, they're not actually attractive, but they are sexy.
Do you mean the way they act?
Yeah. just how they speak and what they wear and how their vibe.
Yeah, I mean,
I see what you mean.
It differs per person, isn't it? Some people are superficial, some people are, but generally, the view is that guys are superficial and will go off looks, and women are more stimulated by mental shit.
Do you not find that that has become less of a, like when you were younger, maybe the standards were here, or like it was about visuals or whatever, but now it's about connection and chemistry and shit.
You could be like Angelina Jolie and be fucking dull as dishwater and just like...
True, true.
Good for one nail though, right? Oh, you were past that now?
Well, no, like to say that you have...
You were trying to put numbers up when you were a bit younger.
Yeah, but like to say that you have done, but like if it's shit in the end, you're just like I kind of try and like, obviously not anymore because I'm fucking taken, but up until not being taken, I just try and not entertain like mega fit birds because I'd be like,
there's no way they're gonna be cool. Was that the vibe?
Pretty much, yeah. Like in most cases, it's just like fucking rubbish.
Yeah.
When you've been that hot, like, and say if you've been good looking all your life, you don't have to develop a
you
personality.
You get invited to the party anyway.
Yeah, like...
Yeah, true.
You don't have to work hard, do you?
Yeah,
well. It's like getting given a job because you know someone. It's like you don't have to work for it, so...
I think it's similar to if a guy has got some modicum of power, either in his career or money quite a lot of the time, people will react or the opposite sex... Or whoever's attracted to him, opposite sex or same sex, whatever, who he's having romantic relationships with, he's not going to get a good gauge on whether he's good looking or not. Like a Harvey Weinstein, he won't have thought...
Yeah, but wouldn't there be a bit of like blackmail involved there?
How many people nailed Weinstein and are just silent about it now because they were like, yeah, I'll
suck
you off.
Who do you reckon did it and hasn't said anything?
I can't think of actresses. We could go through some
Do you want to go through a list? Who do you reckon, man?
I reckon Tarantino's fucking sucked him off, man.
Really?
Yeah.
Tarantino would suck a man off.
Yeah, give me that five.
Did you not see
baby.
Once Upon a Time in Hollywood and he got that scene with Brad Pitt with his shirt off, which is like gratuitous, isn't it, really? It really
know
is.
What that word means.
But my point is, like, how many, there'll be dozens, how many women will have done the dirty with Weinstein just because, like, yeah, whatever. And he would have just thought, like, yeah.
Yeah. You just went, yeah. Well, like he was fucking...
Yeah, he won't know that.
Like he was like, an extra on Shaft or something like, yeah.
He won't know that he's doing rapes is my point. He'll be like, some of these birds are into it.
They're into me telling them they have to fucking fuck
me. He doesn't know.
Like Louis fucking banging one out on his belly.
How many people are incensed by this? But like... For the record, we're not all just like, yeah.
I think we're maybe somewhere in the middle of the argument.
Yeah.
Maybe leaning towards.
We understand
the
positions of
side.
Power and stuff, but
100%.
I think a lot of men find it hard to understand how it feels to be like physically and sexually intimidated, but.
Intimidated.
You know, like physically and sexually intimidated by someone. Okay. Because
My point really wasn't about like, yeah, these women, what they complaining about. I was saying there are guys who won't be aware that they are having, that they're coercing women.
Yeah.
Because they've been in situations where women are responding to their power. Yeah, that's all I was saying.
I've been in situations where I've literally just done something out of politeness because I'm like, oh, I don't want to like upset them and say no.
Yeah.
Like the first time I had sex, man, I really didn't want to fuck a man, but like, I just was like, I can't say no.
Yeah,
like,
I've had sex with
you. But you don't
sex.
Feel like it was rape though for you, do you?
Well, no, I don't feel like in my soul, but if I was to tell you what happened, you'd be like, if you reversed it onto like, say a woman, you'd be like, what the fuck? What?
Yeah, but we're saying that doesn't mean, I wasn't asked, so women shouldn't be asked. We're saying it is definitely different for a male because there's not as much threat involved and the power dynamic is totally different, male to female, so it's like flipped on its ear when it's the other way around. So even though we've been in these positions, like you both have, where you've like, and I've sort of been in those positions where you're like, I'm not really interested in nailing this chick, but it'd be rude not to. Mm. Like those experiences are in no way equipping us with the experience that a girl must have in similar situations.
That's the individual and how you feel in yourself. It can be any situation or any type of thing.
I got that. Do you not remember there was that gay dude that was like trying to get me to get my knob out that time.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
And I was scared. And this was a little dude, diminutive guy. Like, if it was...
Wait, what happened? Like, he was just creeping.
The story is, I'm at this party. I thought it's a party, but then all of a sudden I'm like, this is a fucking networking thing. I realised halfway through that everyone's like, oh, so what do you do? Yeah, I'm with this agency, so did it.
And it's like, I thought you were going to say orgy then. Like, I realised I was at an orgy.
Maybe it turned into one after I left. But it was definitely this industry powwow thing. And I was like, oh, now I feel dirty. I thought we were just here for actual good times, not to like network.
Mm.
So I'm chatting to this guy, and like everyone is doing that, and models are coming over and just going, yeah, I'm here with this person. And I was like, oh, for fuck's... And I was chatting to this one guy who was actually cool, and he was chatting to, and he was saying, oh, I used to be a curator at this art, this gallery, and I lived in Japan for a bit. I was like, this guy gets it. He had nothing to try and gain from me or glean from me, do you know what I mean? I was just like,
having
yeah.
a chat.
Yeah, and it
so you thought.
It's a gay dude. He was talking about his boyfriend at one point. I'm like showing him pictures of my missus and stuff.
Yeah.
And he's going, oh, yeah, she's hot. And so he'd said, like, Tanya was hot. And then he showed me his fella, and his fella was like a swimsuit model or something, some Swedish fucking like bodied up guy. So I was like, oh yeah, your fella's hot, you know, just like returning the compliment. And he was hot. And then he was like, yeah, his dick's like 10 inches long. And I was like, good, yes. You know, I was thinking like, fucking hell, I wouldn't like that up inside my anus. You know what I mean?
So his cock's 10 inches, how tall was this guy?
The guy that I was chatting to,
yeah, the guy
he was short. It was definitely stabbing him in the bottom of the heart.
Shorter than Big Daddy Z.
Similar height, yeah. A very short guy like Zach, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
He was your height, man. He was like a little short, on the shorter side. And then at one point, I'm just like, oh, yeah. And I thought, I need to get out of here, actually, because it's like, you know, it's getting on a bit. And
This guy won't stop speaking about cock.
Well, no, that guy was fine, but the rest of the party, I wasn't vibing. So I was like, I'm a bounce, I'm going to go back to Manchester now. And the guy was like, oh, yeah, I'll walk with you. And I was like, sweet. And we started leaving. We're up in this warehouse, like disused warehouse mill sort of thing.
Mm.
And then we're coming down through the floors, and we're on this abandoned floor, like nothing floor. And he's like, oh, 1 second. And he's like, looking on this floor and going around this corner, and I was like, what's up, mate? And he was like, yeah, just... And I was sort of like walking after him, like, what are you looking for? And he went, should we just like get our dicks out? And dude, if you'd have asked me what I would have done in that situation before, I would have gone, I would have laughed and gone like, oh, you should be so lucky on your bike, look, and then just left or whatever. But I was so, I was terrified. And I started running away from him. Because even though it's like, if it had kicked off, I could have prevented this guy from doing a rape on me. Just because he was lying. And I thought I was having a normal interaction with the guy, but he was doing like, doctors, nurses, I'll show you mine if you don't tell your mum. Like, it was really fucking weird that he was lying, which I'm sure girls get all the time, where guys are just I'll drive you home, don't worry about it. Ugh. And they'd been lied to, and then they'd become aware that the guy's trying to nail them. And this guy was doing lies because he wanted to, like, touch tips with me or whatever.
Manipulative.
He was, yeah, he was manipulating me. And I went, no, I'm okay. And I just started running away, and he started running after me going, why, have you got a big knob? And I was like, yeah, my missus says it's okay. And then I'm just running.
Oh, man.
And then we got outside the mill, big metal door, and we're like, ha-ha-ha-ha. And he's going, ha-ha-ha-ha-ha, running after me. I go, no, I don't know. Yeah, you know, I don't know. No, I'm okay. Let's just... Noisy. Running down the stairs. The iron door just slams shut, and we're out in the silent night. You bloody bastard ruining my story with that phone.
Very professional.
That's all good. Do you want to take it or not?
Oh, it's not a car, it's just been a little
bit. I don't understand these bloody newfangled devices, mate. We get out in the night, it's just deadly quiet, awkward because of what's just happened. And we're just together, alone in the night after the. And I need a piss bad. But I'm like, I sort of don't want to get my dick out.
Can you just suck the piss out of it while you're pissing?
Well, the criticism of people. Sometimes, like, people will accuse each other of being homophobic, like, oh yeah, just because someone's gay doesn't mean they fancy you, like because straight dudes will just be like, as long as they don't bring it near me, then it's all right. But this guy,
he made it very clear.
Yeah,
he made it very clear that he wanted to see.
So I was like, I'm not going
to
get the thing out that what he asked me to get out. So I'm like walking, bladder splitting, walking back to Manchester, and he's walking behind me, just the conversation has changed. He's chatting about something else, but that's all I can think about. Is this.
Wait, he's trying to have a normal conversation.
Yeah, he's just like,
you know?
Yeah, so anyway, when I was in Tokyo, and I'm just thinking
about...
Are
you not just like,
a minute ago
you
wanted
off?
To do sex stuff. So, yeah, I wanted him to leave, but I was like, it's awkward, and he's like a cute little dude. If it was a bigger guy, I'd be like, I'm going, but I felt tight on him because he had like a, I don't know, like a, don't know, it was like he had a unthreatening presence, but then still had done this thing a minute ago. So, by the way, I cannot imagine what girls are going through when there's a guy what's bigger than them.
Yeah.
If they could, if they wanted to take it, they could. And it's guys that you couldn't, you know, the average girl can't take the average guy in a fight, so it's a 6 foot guy or whatever. Can't imagine how they feel. But this guy's walking with me for ages. And then just before we parted ways, because I needed a piss bad, I was like, I need to just make up an excuse to bounce now because I need to have a wee terribly. So I was like, I'm going this way anyway. And he went, oh, okay. And we started walking different directions. And then he turned over his shoulder. He was like, sorry about before.
Fucking hell.
Like he acknowledged it. Like he knew that it was weird. And I went, yeah, well, it was just fucking weird, wasn't it? I don't know you, so. And I just carried on walking. He was like, okay. And then I'm sure he said something like, I'll add you on MySpace, or I'll add you on. He said some like weird website. I was like, oh, okay. And then
that was the end of it. You're like, I'll friend you on Bieber.
Yeah. Well, that was a long story to say. I was in a situation that I'm sure girls have got a fucking dozen stories that are similar to.
Yeah.
And I was scared by a guy that was smaller than me. And girls, most of those stories are going to be about guys that are bigger than you. So every girl we know has had so many of those stories. Like,
a lot of creepers.
Because you could literally like verbally and physically batter that guy easily.
Verbally batter him.
Yeah, verbal bashing, isn't it? But like because of that deceitfulness and that surprise attack, it's just like just catches you off, man.
For people that don't know you guys, like a little brief, I don't know, have you got a little summary, little bio?
I don't want people to know me.
Yeah, you're not asked, are you?
No, man, I'm fucking sick of people.
But we're,
you're my friend.
We're mates from college though.
I don't see you like enough. I don't want
that's true
new man. People fucking
it should be
me.
More. And Zach, what would you describe yourself as these days?
Like now?
Yeah. Would you say labourer, or is that like a naughty word in trades?
No, because I work in a factory now, don't I?
You helped me build this treehouse. so wait, you don't work on houses no more?
No, no.
Wait, you're not a plasterer anymore?
No, I just work in a fucking factory, just making shit.
When do you get time to rub one out then? Because when you used to work on people's houses, you just go off to the half-made bathroom or whatever.
Just got bog in it.
Dayer. Flavours them.
Daya.
So what do you make in this fucking factory?
Tile backboards.
Although this is riveting podcast stuff, but let's change the topic anyway. You guys got any cool rape stories where you guys got raped? Have you been sexually molested?
I mean, like, in the eyes of the law, yeah, but I mean, I didn't feel like it, you know, I was just like, whatever.
Didn't you have a story where you, like, woke up and you were like, what?
Yeah, that was all right, because it was just me in his house.
I've had two instances where I've been like, if you role reversed it and told someone that story, they'd be out for blood. Like, they'd be like, that's not cool.
Okay, yeah,
no. I meant when you were a kid and
and you
woke up.
Woke up feeling a little bit fizzy in my knob, and I'm like, what's going on?
Yeah, but you were around, like...
Crackheads.
Yeah.
For a little backstory,
oh, like your dad went away for a bit, didn't he, when you were young?
He went away.
Yeah,
went what you say to a child who patronizes
him. Did he go to that farm?
Went to the big house.
Yeah. And he's there with all his mates. He'll be back soon.
My dad went HMP out, of course.
Yeah, I didn't know how much you wanted to divulge, but.
Give a fuck. Fuck you, Iggy. What the fuck you gonna do, motherfucker? Bring the smoke.
Yeah, so your dad went to, he did some time for...
selling heroin and crack cocaine.
But it used to hang out with, you know, like, ladies of the night and stuff, right?
Pretty much all of his girlfriends were prostitutes.
But was it one of them that you thought maybe was a weird...
No, right, so I told this story, actually, the other day to someone. So, like, basically, like, when I was younger, my dad would, like... just like couch surfing various crack dens and like different weird crackheads houses, and he lived in a flat with this guy for a bit. I think he was called Dave, and he had this big Alsatian that used to jump up and try and lick his knob. And he'd be
Alsatian's
like,
the lot.
Yeah, and he'd be like, Benji. The dog was called Benji. You're like, Benji, get down, stop it.
Not while we've got visitors.
In it, and dog would be trying to lick his knob. And
the dog would be like, you're always putting peanut butter on your
knob. Yeah, like, have you not got a freaking...
I'm like 8 years old, like, what the fuck is this guy, right? His actual name was Dave, but we called him Catman, right? That's what they call him, Catman. He's a
does not sound
like
good.
A shit superhero.
He's a smackhead who lives in a flat in Ifold. His name's Catman, and his fucking Alsatian licks his knob, right? And I would kip there on the weekend with my dad, right?
Oh, and no.
When my dad would go out scoring smack or like doing whatever, he'd leave me with Catman and this Alsatian.
Your mum knew what your dad was up to, or
not at all.
And were you aware at that age, like, something's up, or is it only? Have you retrofitted the memories?
From what I remember, I think I felt like really anxious. I didn't want to like say anything. It just made me feel like really like scared. I was just like, I can't say anything. Like, I'm not fucking grass, mate.
Yeah.
But so she never found out until he went to prison.
Wow.
Mm.
Yeah, which was when I was.
And were you shocked, or were you like, oh, that makes sense? Or were you like, what, prison?
Well, I didn't fully know what it was. Like, he went to prison when I was, like, just starting high school. Because it's funny, actually, because my first day of high school, I remember me and James, like, we used to catch the bus to high school together, and he lived, like, a couple of doors down from me. And I'd, on my first day of high school, gotten a letter from my dad in prison. It was the first letter I'd gotten. I read it, and I was, like, crying, going, oh, my dad's in prison. Don't know what it means. And I'm crying my eyes out, and I go downstairs, and James is crying, and I'm like, why are you crying? He's like, my hamster's just died. I was like, that was our first day at high school. Dad's in prison and James's hamster's fucking died.
Fucking hell.
So Catman, right, he would go out scoring gear and leave me in this flat with this guy called Catman who's Alsatian, licks his dick. And he'd be like, Ben, oh, get down, stop it.
Oh, no.
And then that was just that. That was a weird situation where I'd be like, this guy makes me feel really nervous.
Yeah, this is a horrible story.
This is horrible, man.
And
what would you do during the, like, what, when your dad's out? What, like, are you just like hiding in a room or something?
Well, no, like I'd play like PlayStation with him and stuff, and he'd just be weird. And I always remember
on GTA just killing prostitutes.
That was another story. But I always remember feeling really unnerved by him, and he was really creepy and just this little anorexic crackhead thing that was just he was just a fucking ball of bad energy, right? And it wasn't a good time just being around him. And I was like, I look back and I go, why would you leave your son with this weird bastard? And I remember later years, like maybe being late teens. And I remember I said to my dad, I was like, do you remember Catman? He went, oh yeah, Catman, yeah, Dave. Wait, why did they call him Catman? He went, oh, like someone caught him doing something. What was the word he used? Some weird word. Like someone caught him doing something innocuous with a cat. And I was like, what? He was like, yeah, he just was like touching some cat or some weird
inoculating
shit.
Inoculating a cat?
Yeah. I don't know what that fucking word means. But like, he was like, yeah, he was just fucking mauling about with a cat. So everyone on the estate called him
Catman.
Wait,
so he's went to the effort to like catch a cat? Because cats are pretty quick.
Yeah. Respect.
And he's what? Started putting his finger up the cat's ass,
like,
or something.
Sexually assaulting a cat.
And then like loads of people walk around the corner just seeing him just...
So they was like, let's call him Catman. And then my dad just chills on his couch and thinks it's cool to leave me in the flat with him on my own for hours while I get smacked up.
And your old man was like, hell. Yeah, it sounds like a good lad.
Right.
Like a good lad. It's a good job you're not very cat-like.
Meow.
But now would you like me to be the cat?
But like, and I said to him, what happened to Catman? He went, no, he fucking hung himself. I don't know his second name, but he's called Dave. Dave the Catman.
Dave Catman,
he had an
What happened to the dog dying?
If anybody from Higher Fold is watching and remembers Dave Catman with Benji the Alsatian, please message in.
Reach out.
We'd love to know any updates. Well, he's dead, but... Yeah, that fucking... like, how mad is that, right? And then think, be a normal, just fucking cognitive adult and think, is that fucking cool? He'd be like, no, it's not. It's funny, though.
Man.
I love it when he tells his stories.
That's not even the worst shit.
I know it gets worse.
Have you got any fight stories or like narrow misses? We were chatting about fights before we started the pod, you know, like...
I've been banged out once. I've never been in a battle.
A fisticuffs.
I've had like little punch-ups or something, but I've never, like...
Yeah, I've never had a one-on-one where you just, like...
battle with a man to the death.
One?
It never works like that, though. It's always, like...
2 points to you.
Clumsy fucking...
In it.
Have you been in a couple fights?
Not really, not, like, scraps. Like, not, nothing.
Yeah. I've been in, like, weird, messy brawls, but never just, like, me and a guy fighting.
I find it hard to get angry.
Like, yeah, you've said before you've been raging... And you just like, you go out of that house thinking like, I wish someone had tried it today. Like, I'm fucking, hey! But then no one ever does. And then when you're in a good mood, someone like punches you and you're just like, what are you doing that for?
He's like, what's going on? Like, you fucking, like, oh, what is life?
Shall we watch some videos?
Yeah, man.
Well, go on, then, what have you got?
I've got some prepared.
Have you got like something horrific?
Nothing too crazy, because well, originally before we were chatting about what we want to do on the pod, and Zach's idea was we all dress up as Taliban because of the Taliban thing going on right now.
I'd definitely get fired.
Yeah, but
100%.
It's not going to be
game over.
Would you actually get fired for that? Possibly. You don't work for the council or anything, do you? Like,
yeah, but it's a big company.
Yeah, so I've got some here, and we'll stick them on. If you're just listening, we'll describe what's going on. I think
like a radio play.
Yeah, like a radio play.
There's no audio on these.
There'll be a bit of audio, yeah.
I can't imagine what any of those videos are.
So it's a guy shooting a TikTok, most likely. If you see people doing weird shit, dancing, it's probably a TikTok, innit?
What the fuck's that? Is that...
Oh, shit!
Should we get that one more time?
One more time.
That's amazing. Wait, who's hanging out like the back window? Is that like a person or?
What's she doing? Like, he's doing this thing and she's
right,
like,
she's let the handbrake off and it's rolling forward. It's
man, that's
fuck
really
off
got to hurt.
And watch. Then her ankle gets caught. Oh, it snaps, man.
Oh,
that
it snaps in half.
Snaps in half. Yeah. What a dickhead.
Let's get some more in that sort of vein.
Go on.
Yeah, there's no sound on this one. Someone's trying to escape a traffic stop.
Oh!
Whoa! He's fine. Yo, did you see his shoes came off?
That guy's invincible.
Watch it again. The guy runs away across a motorway. He's hit.
Bang.
He jumps over.
His shoe went into orbit.
Yeah, his shoe's gone.
He jumped over a car.
And meanwhile, in Ukraine.
An argument on live TV in
Moldova. Oh, the guy on the left's going to swing, man. He's ready for it.
You think the left... Yeah, you called it.
Oh! Oh, the fucking...
Old man fight.
Why are they not breaking it up?
The librarian's got him, man. Oh, he's got
him. Whoa, he ragged him. You
get
kill
the
him.
Fuck out of here.
You just got knocked out by the librarian, man.
Brilliant.
We watch that again.
Let's watch that one more time.
That was... Yeah, because the fucking... The bald guy on the left is fucking ready to go.
He fucking smoked him.
Yeah, look at him.
Oh,
he fucking...
yeah. He started it.
The librarian's just calm as fuck, man.
I reckon he's putting it on, you know, when he drops as well.
He's got that granddad energy.
Oh, little jab. And then he just gets him in a rear naked.
Just goes,
drags him to the floor.
No, he's putting it on because he didn't even get enough of a grab on his neck to, like, put him out.
That was like when the guy, what was that massive guy called from Tilsley who ran Cadence?
Oh, Ian Jackson.
Didn't he?
Is that a euphemism for something?
Didn't he spark someone out on CCTV and the guy was like,
he fucking sucker punched someone from behind.
Oh.
Pussy.
Next one.
Oh!
Oh, he's dead. He's fucking dead.
Maybe I should have proof watched.
That was a neck snap, that one. So there's a big fucking wheel and then he's dead.
Oh my
he's
god.
He's dead.
Dude, and on
he's fucking
things
dead,
on
man.
Camera look smaller than they feel. You know, like if you're up a ladder,
heights.
It looks not.
It looks
high.
Like mate, that was eighth of the size.
That might have been a three-story drop, and he landed on his head.
Yeah,
or at least his neck.
He's okay. He's fine.
Nice fuck.
Next one. Oh, you must have seen this one.
Yeah, oh, yeah, I've seen that one.
Oh.
This is a classic.
He's fucking brutal.
Fucking hell.
Okay, so there's a guy on a roof.
Oh, the knees go backwards.
That is tough to watch.
Why do you jump in from there, man?
Shall we watch it one more time?
Yeah, do it.
He's fucked. That guy's fucked.
Listen, no more Sunday league for that cunt.
Classic, that one. Let's see what we got next.
Why did he jump from there, man?
No, I'm good.
Last episode that you were on, we watched loads of shit from Live Leak, and that week Live Leak went down, and it was over. By the way, is it
mine and your fault then?
It could be. By the way, the guy that ran Live Leak is from Manchester. I think he's from Salford or something. Like, he's from
what? Nearby.
How crazy is that?
What?
That's bananas.
And he's just like some family guy who's like, oh, I can't be arsed with it anymore. But I've been looking for a new one for ages.
Found it.
Yeah, this website I've got these from is just called Item Fix.
Item Fix.
Okay.
Which, it started off really embarrassing. It was like TikTok, so it was loads of like inexplicable fucking annoying sound stuff on top of it. You know, when you watch TikToks and it's like, I tried to do this to my boyfriend, and it's like text-to-speech shit. And just,
and it makes you want to kill yourself.
Yeah, just cancer for the brain. But that's how it started, and now it's gone back into a bit more Live Leak territory.
Well, to be fair, is it because everyone on Live Leak has nowhere to post crazy shit anymore?
Yeah, 100%. We need an avenue for these videos.
They've found a new home.
Let's see what we got next. Oh, a dog versus a snake.
No, the dog's fucked, man. Dogs are stupid as fuck.
Yeah. Who's filming this?
It's probably Russia, man. They don't give a shit. Whoa!
No.
Oh, I let my fucking dog, my pet.
To be fair, the dog didn't shit out then when it got bit. Some animals go, oh, I didn't realise it was going to be real.
No, dog's game. Oh, it's got him!
Woohoo! He tagged him!
Holy
Just ragdolling the snake.
The snake's ribs just smacking
up
the dog's head.
The snake cannot have survived that.
I guess
he's chewing his head and whipping his body around.
I guess this is one of the reasons to have a dog, you know, home defense.
I respect that dog.
You can send the dog out first.
Oh, dog. What? Has he slept him?
Yeah, man. The snake's
dude, it's over.
Fucked. He's playing with it now.
Dude, he shuffled. He like shuffled
good
his
boy.
Head.
Good boy.
Training it to kill snakes or something.
That's fucking brilliant. What have you put on? Sex pot. Hey, fucking see you later, mate.
I'll see you later, mate. Right, yeah, so I got a couple, you know, like adverts, PSAs.
Catman.
Catman was driving that car, that's what he survived that car crash.
We've got a few more PSAs.
Oh, I've seen this shit. This is hilarious.
Did you see there was a couple frames of her like scalded?
What the fuck?
I think that's got us back on track with the vibe.
Right. Oh, fuck you know.
Yo,
they killed that fucking rubber dummy, man.
One more of these.
Well, yeah, fuck it, why not?
Elena didn't think anyone would hurt her. Elena trusted everyone. Maria doesn't trust anyone. Elena wanted to learn English. Maria gets beaten if she says no. Elena worked in a market to support her family. Maria works for nothing. Elena wanted to help people and be a nurse. Maria services up to 40 men a day. Elena used to cry when her father was cross with her. Maria doesn't feel anything anymore.
Oh my God.
Elena's family thinks she's dead.
Help me.
Oh no.
I was Elena. I am Maria. Help me. I'm here.
Holy shit. I did not watch that before I played it.
Can you get that whiskey, actually?
We might have to get some whiskey.
Get the fucking whiskey.
Go get the fucking whiskey, man.
Yo, dude, she said that her family thinks she's dead. And then she just goes, help me. That is brutal. Make it happy, Zach. That's you.
What you got, Zach?
It's fucking sent under that, man. That's fucking heavy, that, man.
We'll have a little break for a second, I think.
I mean, I was so happy when that kid, when all those kids died under that car.
The kids dying was funny
as fuck. Can we watch that one again?
There's a good one.
Shall we watch the kids dying one?
Please.
No, there's a good one. Try and find it on YouTube. I might have sent it to you. It's an advert about gun crime.
And it's like the family at the table.
Yeah, if you can find that.
I don't think we're going to laugh at it.
Just fucking, you might as well, innit? Oh, why? Why did you show us that?
Why did you show us that? We're having such a good time.
I really spoiled them.
You ruined everything.
I don't want to go on.
No, we'll have a whiskey, we'll be all right.
I apologise. I just looked at PSAs, like one in dark PSAs, and I thought that I'd seen the car flipping.
The car was amazing, man. That's my favourite video ever.
I remember seeing them ages ago. I hadn't rewatched them, but I saw the thumbnails. I know those ones. And then I just downloaded like four more. And that Emma Thompson one.
Type in Southwark Council Sunday lunch.
Right, I got it. We'll watch it.
Why
are you up? What's up? It spoiled it a little bit.
Oh, man, look at my fish fingers.
What's up?
No.
I'm going to pick up the kids from school tomorrow.
Yeah, if you don't mind.
No, blood. That reverse deal was big,
aren't it? Hey, no, it was
huge.
I bet you any money, Anton flipped the show.
Hey, you always.
Doesn't matter what the occasion, birthday, christenings, my man always finds a way.
I'll tell you something, though. It's a good thing you might never come, because it was a big hype thing going about last night.
See, that's why I like having younger brothers and sisters. I stay indoors while the beef stays outside.
Fucking hell!
Oh my god!
That's cheering me up there, that
Holy
one.
Shit!
Yo.
Oh fucking hell, man!
That fucking cheered me up, that one.
A poor kid, man, he's just fucking.
There was one, there's no way we'd be able to find it, but it was like an elderly lady falls in a house and she can't reach the phone and she just goes, hell. And no one's
I've
there.
Fallen and I can't get up.
The best one is, which was hard to find for years and years and years and years and years and years. And then we found it. I don't know if you'll be able to find it now. BNBN.
Oh, yeah.
So good, man.
Yeah, this guy's trying to not get killed, so he just starts singing BNBN.
Like, he's a Welsh shit way of
life. Out in this cold field with a grave dug in front of him, and he's on his knees in front of the grave, and there's a guy like
with a gun to the back of his head.
And he just goes, BNBN. And then the guy with the gun goes, and they get through all BNBN. We get more into it.
It caps him.
I think the listeners would love to hear us rating some of the Pretendship guests, you know, some of our mates.
Could get a bit catty, that.
No, not as guests, though. We're talking about, you know, a Johnny or
as
a
people.
Darby, whatever.
As people.
To shag.
It's mostly been guys that have been on your podcast.
That's it. Johnny, could he get it?
I mean, he has licked my dick and balls, technically.
It's really? A long story, but it's accurate, that, yeah.
It is actually true. And I have wanked him off, but not in a gay way.
It was a little, like, drug-fueled wait, hang on a minute.
Like, how do you wank him off and not in a gay way? Were you just, like, not, and, you're and not looking at him? Like,
if fucking... you're leathered with Zach and you're, like, having a piss, you'll be taking a piss in your urinal and his head will appear and just be like,
and like, I got called out before closing the door. He's like, why are you closing the door? It's like, because I know you're going to try and grab my cock. Oh, you fuck. What, you queer? Do you not want me to fucking get, like, feel your balls and let your cock?
Within the same 30 seconds, I wanked Johnny off and fucking grabbed his pissing cock and put it in my mouth. It wasn't gay, though. Like, it was like...
No, 100%. That's totally straight, mate.
No, what it was is, like, we were queuing up to go in somewhere and there was a fucking... There was, like, a line of police down King Street. Do you remember this one? Like, there'd be big nights. So,
wait, so hang on a minute. So you got about 30 seconds to get in and, like, you wanked Johnny up. Like, how good are you at wanking people up?
Right, now what were happening is we were queuing to get into this place. And
I'm
was,
pissing while we're queuing.
You were, like, pissing on the side of the building and me and Johnny were, like, just fucking knobbing about, just being dickheads. And there was, like, a fucking line of police because what used to happen is when there was big nights, certainly, they'd get loads of police at Middle Road and they'd watch all the clubs and if there was any trouble... They could literally be on it pretty quick. Okay. And
dude, we've seen some mad things out in Lee before.
I had this bet with Johnny, right? I was like, I bet I can get arrested before you. And Johnny went, no chance. I bet I can get arrested before you. Watch this. He was shouting at the police. I was like, oh, you fucking know it's me. Just trying to get their attention. I said, get your dick out now. He got his dick out. I was going, what are you fucking thinking about? You fucking pigs, wait. And he was just like staring at us. Next thing, he's like pissing on this fucking pub. I said, fucking you, come here now. And he's still like got his dick dribbling and that. I was like,
do you know, our night out move was try and walk down the street while you're pissing. Do you remember that one?
Yeah.
So you're just walking, pissing in like a zigzag down the middle of the road.
Oh, man. Speaking of pissing on that.
Go on.
How the fuck? No, it weren't even me, it was you. We're like, how the fuck we both didn't get it back? Do you remember Piss Wank?
Shaky Piss Wank, yeah. You'd be in the urinal and you get your dick out and then as you're pissing, you just give it a bit
piss wang! Pissed off over these two guys.
You piss, oh, piss shit. Is going everywhere.
Flying everywhere. On the lucky lucky man, on the ceiling, on the tiles, on these two fucking...
Man, we've nearly got booted out of Lee clubs a few times.
I've been kicked out of every club in Lee for fingering someone.
Yeah.
That's true.
Mostly guys, that's the problem, isn't it?
Probably the same bird.
Wait, you nailed someone outside the back of Quay and it was on the CCTV.
Is that the CCTV footage? It's silent and you just see Zach shouting
at
Rambe.
Not just CCTV. It was accurate. Like 30 people.
What, just stood there just watching you? Just freaking...
Yeah. It was a...
Like a zoo.
Mate, it was a fucking mad night that night. Like,
that's brilliant.
Do man. I what like? Do we just leave it at that?
You don't have to name her.
I know, but like, some people might know who they are and get upset by it.
Yeah.
The main character won't get upset. She'll be like, yeah, she's a lad. She won't be, but someone who loosely connected to it might be like,
yeah, maybe just leave it.
Really?
I basically shagged someone at the side of a bin, and loads of people watched and filmed it.
Shouts to anyone who goes out in Lee, Vegas. Do you reckon it still happens now? Like, I feel like it's dead Lee now. Like, I've not been to Lee in years.
I think we're just out of that crowd.
But there's no way it's as good as it once was.
Never. Not a chance. It was brilliant.
Because no one's shagging anyone behind.
Honestly, there was a time in my life where I was like, I love this more than I love anything.
And that's what it was. Every week it was out of control. There's like climbing on the roof. People had like... shagging each other in the corner, getting kicked out,
even
fights, glass.
It wasn't even...
Do you remember there was like a 30-man brawl, the police turned up
all the time. Not even that, though. That wasn't even the best bit, man. Just like everybody just in love and just like happy and just like weightless and just like, oh, this is the only thing that matters right now. And then everyone grew up and life got shit and I just feel like topping myself.
But we might end up out in town later. Maybe you're a yes. I'm a yes. How do you feel about it?
I can't be a pussy now, can I? So I have to say
you
yes.
Can't be a pussy. It's a school little, night. Little shiny, sexy space vodka man.
You were, yeah, we have to retain the get up. The club.
You want to get wanked off or not?
Hey, remember when we watched that snake, the crack snake film?
It's fucking brilliant. Oh, hey guys!
What was like me and you were around?
Basilisk. That's what it's called. Yeah, we found it.
Yeah, we found it. The crack snake. What was going on that day? Because we turned up at your house.
He didn't even watch it. He was like, here, guys, I've got to edit this video. I'm basically getting paid a fucking chicken and chip barn for doing a music video.
And me and you was getting pissed in his front room.
Getting levered watching a fucking B movie about a fucking serpent snake dragon.
Hey, it's me, the crack snake. How you doing?
I have no memory of what you're on about.
Meanwhile, Chris Hall's pissed himself and asleep on the couch.
For viewers who don't know, Chris Hall's my dad. My house used to be the common area, the clubhouse. Everyone would come around there. There'd be up to like 20, 30 people in my room sometimes.
Insane.
Getting on it, raving. We'd have raves in there, pilled up, smoking, drinking, whatever. And my parents weren't cool. And you're thinking, oh, what? That's hippie parents or what? They didn't like it. They were like, get out, we'll ring the police. They would say shit like this, but I was a piece of shit.
Like, I feel bad about that.
Yeah.
And you know what now? Like, I'm not, I really mean this, but like, fucking pandemic's been shit as fuck, right? I swear to God, one of my only, like, not my only reason, but like, one of my main motivations for getting two vaccinations and like being a good lad, I'm thinking,
visit my parents.
I can't wait to give Alison a hug. I fucking love it, bits. Like, and like, I feel like she understands. I feel like she understands that we were like little dickheads when we were younger, but it was all out of love. But like, oh, fuck
I think she is like, with all my friends, she's like, yeah, no, I understand what it was like. And she's cool with them all now. But with you, she was still like, I did try and get the police to kick Zach out a few times.
But that the way you got to look at that is it's just
he's
energy.
Like, they're asleep and he's putting his bollocks on their heads. And he's like, he's screaming racial epithets out of the window. And they're going, what are you doing? What are you doing?
I was remember that time, like, I fucking crashed at yours. And I was like, fucking pissed. And you were like, yeah, it's Calzonio, just sleep there. I was like, yeah, all right.
You slept in the living room on the couch.
And all of a sudden, like, I'm pissed up. And this piano music starts playing. Like, full blast. Like,
we're talking 4 a.m.
Yeah, fucking definitely. I'm like, what the fuck's going on? I look up, and your fucking old man's there, like, fucking trying to be fucking Mozart, and then he just looks around at me and like looks at me like that. I look at him, I just go, fuck.
Yeah, fair enough, it's your house.
Yeah, right. Like, you can't buy experiences like that. You can't. Honestly, if you could, I'd give someone fucking 10 grand just to live one of them weird moments again. It's like, yes.
Zach's had a lot of those experiences with my parents, with my dad specifically. One time, Zach was flicking the light on and off or something.
I love the way he tells his story. He like,
wait, you tell it.
He's half right, but
you tell it. I'll tell it the truth. The real truth.
The truth.
Chris jumps up and he's like, who's turning that bloody light on and off? And Zach's like, And so my dad, for listeners, the man is physically infirm. Severely mentally ill.
He's quadruspasmed.
He's quadruspasmed. But he's medicated. You know, he's on the full gamut of action, which makes him brutally constipated, tranquilized, like everything. Name it. He's not having a good time. He's a write-off, my old man.
And he's a mental nutcase.
But he jumps up and he's like, who's bloody doing that? Zach's like, goes back down. He just sleeps on the couch. He slept on the couch ever since I was a little kid. And then Zach's like, turning the light on and off. And then Chris jumps up like, you fucking doing that? If you do it again, I'm about to spat you out. And Zach's like,
from my point of view, right,
Chris boss you. Did you boss you, man?
Chris bitched me about it. No, right. We was having a giggle, and it was just a giggle. And the thing is, right, Chris and his daft dad, like, he probably would, like, think he wants to smoke, right, and maybe go there.
But you don't want that.
But in my head, I'm thinking, right?
You don't win any points for it.
Yeah, 100%. I understand.
Right, and like, I don't want to fight him. Like, I'm not being all thingy, but like, I would batter him, like, even though he...
Yeah, that's the point
he's got nice
at.
Hands, he's nice with it.
That's the point I'm laughing at, because he suddenly goes, who's fucking flicking that light off? And you just went, oh, sorry, he just went, yeah.
Well, yo, you just got to let him have one, aren't you?
I don't know, I think Grizz and Zach could have a good fight.
Fuck off.
I don't know who's going to win.
Who's your money off? Honestly, who's your money on?
I don't know, because it's not the size
he
of the...
He doesn't know, fucking hell.
It's not the size
he's
of the dog in the
shit
fight.
About you now.
It's the fight in the dog.
Well, there's no fighting that dog, it's all in his head.
You want to bet... You don't want to go to prison. Chris, nothing to lose. His life is terrible.
No,
he'll kill you. You're in trouble
he
now.
He thinks that you're an alien trying to penetrate his mind or something. Do you know what I mean?
He's going
to
go nuts.
He don't want the smoke.
It's going to be McGregor versus Aldo all over again, man. He's going to get in his head.
He's got mental strength.
It goes like this, right? It happens and I go, and he has a go at me and I go, right, okay. And then I look like a pussy. I guess it's pretty... Whatever, makes me look a bit shit. But imagine if I'd just gone, all right then, whatever, and he's too proud and fucking puts it on me, so I batter him.
You admitted on this podcast you've not had any fisticuffs. You've not had a fight. Chris has had loads of fights.
He's not had a fight.
He's had lots of fights. He used to fight.
I got to be honest with you, my money's on Chris.
He's like, I boxed a rugby player when I was younger. That's his one story.
He done it.
He fucking never.
My mate sang at Sting's wedding. And I've shared a drink with my cook now.
Yeah, right.
Can we watch?
Listen.
Can we watch fucking Chris's like Christmas music video?
I injured my voice once. I did a video of a lottery winning once.
It simply did not happen. That.
That's him.
Yes, this
he's,
is it.
It's Chris Hall.
This is it. I love this video, man.
This is my dad's Christmas tune.
I love it.
I think I've shown this to Alex.
Big Paddy Peters.
Big
pretend
Paddy
angel
Peters.
Oh, wow.
You know, I always describe this as Chris appears and it looks like a manifesto video, like the Joker in Dark
Knight.
Yeah,
yeah. It's that bit where he sings his little bit.
What you don't know? The Batman.
The Batman.
It looks like a disgruntled ex-mall Santa who got sacked for spice.
You know what though?
Mate, this is like Bad Santa 3. I love it.
I'll fucking give it him. It's grown on me like a tumour because he's a bot.
Can you sing it on Christmas?
Does it feel like Christmas is coming? Tell me that you feel it too. Does it feel like Christmas is coming?
Let's get it to number
Such
one.
Such a special time of year. Holding the old in with the new.
Merry Christmas.
Go on, Chris. Have a very, very merry Christmas.
It looks terrifying.
You know what? If that fucking come on in the club now.
This is the bit, man. Look at him, man. It's literally the Joker from The Dark Knight.
Yo, the guy's got like fake teeth that he didn't put in for the thing. He's like, I can't be arsed.
The thing is though, when he gets the camera light up to his face, they've got this little set, right? And as he's spinning around, you see the fucking seat.
Hey, give all fucking Pete film this, directing it and everything.
Yo. I'm surprised he hasn't asked me to film any of his shit for him.
Peter, Christmas is coming.
Yeah.
Tell me you feel it too.
Tell me it's not grown on you after 11 years.
There
man.
Might be more tunes on that. On that channel.
I'd check
that channel. It's fuck all.
No, you should show Calzonio. We say yeah. There's the fucking guitar solo in that.
We say yeah. What is this?
It's incredible.
This is a tune that he did with Paddy.
Didn't your mum have to drive around for like 7 hours while he filmed
this?
This
is me on the guitar solo.
Look at those little anime eyebrows.
Look at Catman in background. Fucking motherfucker.
No, Benji, they're making guitar solo now.
Stop it, Benji. Oh, stop licking his G-string, Benji.
fuck
oh,
you.
Oh, man. And when fucking, when you go out and get drunks.
I get drunks. I don't just get drunk, drunk, I get drunks.
I can always count on you fucking either ringing me or leaving me a voicemail. You know what I'm going to say, right? And I
stopped, man. I felt bad. I felt like I was mithering
you. Oh, no, it's not so much mithering. More like fucking death threats. Do you know what I mean?
What, try to get you to come out?
No,
I will literally ring him up and tell him I'm going to kill him.
He'd be like, I just get this incoherent fucking 3:43 a.m. fucking message from
Calzonio. Have you got anything safe you could be listening to?
Probably somewhere. And it's just like, you little fucking midget cunt. Fucking hate you. I'll fucking go out and come to Manchester. You know what? Go and fucking kill yourself, you little prick. I'll fucking try and ring you.
You
fucking,
never leave me voice notes.
You think you.
Yeah,
because
only he understands.
Yeah,
you know, I was out with Calzonio.
What did you mean?
What, last weekend?
After
watching the UFC.
Oh, yeah, shit. Good win, times. Tom Aspinall. Looked good.
Zach's met Paddy Pimlet. Met him
really?
At Reebok.
Yeah, me and Big Derbs.
Did he swing for you and like put his chin in the air?
Fucking knocked him out, man.
it's not good, is it? The chin in the air is not good.
No, I want to watch him fight because it's going to be exciting.
Just for people who are not following, who don't give a fuck about it, we're on about MMA, UFC, Paddy Pimlet, Liverpool. Big star, really.
We're scousers, we don't get knocked out.
It's going to be very ironic, that line.
Yeah.
You shouldn't have said that.
People are going to meme it when he gets knocked out.
Or maybe he won't.
Out.
Maybe he won't.
He will
maybe
get
he'll
knocked
dominate.
Out. You can't fight like that and not get knocked out.
True. I think Tom Aspinall's got the best chance, I think.
Honestly.
Yeah, a couple of years.
Like, he's not even like, it's not even like, oh, you know, like, well done, he's all right. Like, he's a fucking legit bad man.
He's,
like,
he's really quick, man. He's scarily
he's,
quick.
He's not like...
For a guy that size,
anyone
man.
Who's listening from... Atherton, Lee, Tilsey, or whatever. We have a guy that is from Atherton who's in the UFC. He's a heavyweight and he's a genuine contender.
I'm not like mega fighting knowledgeable. Like some of the heavyweights that are bigger than it, the big names because they were good once and then they've whatever. Mm. But I feel like he's top 10.
Yeah, it's not a stacked division.
Like, top 10 already.
Not to say that he couldn't do it if it was stacked, but I mean, these are the best men on the planet.
The thing is, though, like, it's his speed, man. He's so fucking quick.
He's like, scary. He didn't get...
That fight last week, man, like...
He didn't get out of first gear. He said afterwards.
Like, Spivak, man, he could not...
Sergei Spivak, yeah.
He was backing up the whole time. He
but
was like, I can't
Tom
fucking
said
get
in a post-fight speech, he was like, oh, I was expecting to go 3 rounds, so I didn't really get out of first gear, and he still looked
And he's
rapid.
Still finished, man.
At 8, he, like, lives around the corner from me, I think. And I remember seeing him on the... I've got a park at the back of my house. And he was just chilling, just like walking about the park, like with his kids and stuff. And I was like, and I thought to myself, I was like, how mad is that? That's like one of the hardest guys in the world.
Yeah,
and he's just humbly walking around this park.
Dude, I always say to people, like the UFC, for people that we know, because there's been a few Atherton heads that have like gotten far in MMA and like all Darren Morris's guys.
Yeah. They fucking mint.
Like Unit 7 guys do well in fighting. Mm. But I always say to people, like, you don't understand the level that they're at in the UFC because you meet people and they're hard. The hardest guy you've ever met, he's not in the UFC. The hardest guy in your city, in your country, is not necessarily good enough to be in the UFC.
Yeah.
And that's
a minefield, man, because anyone can knock anyone out. And
at that weight.
He looks fucking...
He looks incredible.
He never looks in trouble, man.
Brilliant, like...
But he hasn't...
Even against Arlovski, he got tagged, but he didn't quite look into... He didn't look too bad in trouble, man.
A long time since Arlovski's done any damage, like...
But that's still a huge fucking
guy.
Yeah,
he's only just started, and he's young as well. He's younger than us. He's like 28 or something. So I think, give it a few years, he's a force to be reckoned with.
Yeah. Because it's like that thing, like you said, like some people we know have got in the UFC and they've done well, but it's been like, you know, like good debut, decision, loss, decision, win.
Like Darren Till has not had a good performance
not
in,
so great,
in a
but
while.
Fucking Tom, man, he's a train, man.
Yeah.
And is it
because he's not like a fucking like loud mouthed fucking like look at me kind
he's
of thing?
He's dead chilled.
He seems like a chill guy. Like
nice dude.
You know what I mean? I just love fighting.
Yeah, yeah. You know, he always does that shit.
His chin's just out.
Don't take piss, you'll fucking knock your head.
I respect
140 Stanley Street, mate.
I respect Tom, but I'm telling you, These other heavyweights, they've not got the speed to match me, you know what I mean?
I'm a fucking dropping Siggy all over me, son.
I'm going to resell these outfits, Zach. What are you on about?
You have as well, man. There's fucking ash everywhere. Nice one.
You've got ash all over you, man. Let's talk about the Goldberg knob you were on about before.
You got a massive old knob. But no, like...
It's like a trucker's arm, isn't it?
Jesus Christ. Yeah. This is going to be me doing like a freaking like...
Dude, you see my knob. It's got Pete. A leathery patch on it, hasn't it?
We should do some heroin.
Keen?
I'm down.
But...
I feel like you and me have done a fair amount of drugs. Zach's not actually done too many drugs.
Never many drugs.
That might shock viewers.
The first time I ever did cocaine...
We should have said before this pod started, like, it might help for listeners to, like, crack a tinny. You know, have a little Sunday.
Well, it's too fucking late now.
Yeah, because I feel like we've fairly gone off the rails, but if you plan for it...
You
want to
help your mental health? No, cocaine.
No. It's not good, is it? We shouldn't.
Let's be honest, it's not.
Well, no, it makes you feel pretty good.
For full disclosure, Zach, obviously, I mean, if you've listened to past pods, maybe even in this one it's been apparent, struggles a little bit with mental equilibrium, yeah? The neurochemistry, right? So
you'd love MD, man.
I think, yeah, I do think a couple of the more severe drugs, the class A's and stuff, I wouldn't feel comfortable fully just like out and out recommending it to you because there's a come down, there's a price to pay, and I'm not confident that you wouldn't feel fucked up. And I mean, I can't.
Oh, no, if you ever do it, like fucking state of mind.
Yeah, big time. You do need to be with someone.
Well, what fucking a ridiculous film.
I would like it if you would be with someone when you do that shit.
Oh, no, you don't want to do any of that shit.
However, coke, which you have done, I would say is a worse high and a worse come down than MDMA. I feel more and more confident that I think you could deal with any come down of MDMA. I've seen you're a resilient guy. You can deal with, lad, I could not deal with working shifts, night shifts on and off and all that shit.
It ain't that. I deal with that because that's just, it is what it is. And alcohol, I can have a bad hangover and I'm like, but I know it like a bitch. Like, I'm just like, I know where we're going with this, bad or good. But like, coke, for instance, I can have like one or two keys and I can be fucking suicidal for a week or two. I'm like, eh.
Really? The demons come and get you that early?
Bad. Fuck, it's not good for me.
I reckon you'd be better on MD. I reckon you'd be all right. Yeah, definitely.
Yeah,
I reckon you'd be okay.
I would like to. But then again, like, part of me like, oh, I'd love to try it for like various reasons because like people I know are like into it and I'm like, it would just be a good connection experience, but half of me's like, you're fucking 30, you daft cunt. But yeah, man, fucking...
We've had a little wee break.
Pee.
Will you tidy Carl's little fringe up? Come on.
Hey, go on. Do it for me, baby.
Fucking spesh.
Nah, be smooth, man. Be smooth.
How are you? Uncle Smooth Skin.
Be gentle nice. With him.
Nice and nice.
Come on, Catman.
Like, that's a nice little fucking hobbit. Come on, man. Do it right. Do it right, you little bitch.
Shut up, you fucking...
We've all just been for a slash, and you were like, oh, I've got PTSD because... Tell us the story.
What story?
About you humiliating Peter for money.
I think one time...
Oh, yes.
Via me.
All right.
I've spent most of my life...
Okay.
What happened?
Let me give some context, though. Let me give context.
Set the scene.
Because I've spent most of my life...
Set the scene.
...fairly hard up for cash.
He was skin. Grew up desperate.
Grew up skin, and I've been skin till a couple of years ago.
Some little tough.
Now...
Fucking mostly common.
I got a little bit of walking around money, you know, you feel me?
You had nothing, you were desperate that week, I remember it.
I used to, I'm like living check to check on my EMA.
No, we were playing Rich Boys.
Do you remember EMA? Or JSA?
You had no EMA.
I had nothing. But at this point, I think Zach just went off because we were always shitting on things, pissing on things. We were just like weird little kids. We'd just be like, let's go and shit on someone's car. And we just... that's how it was when we were teenagers.
That's what you two were doing.
Yeah, full disclosure.
We were going out.
Callum was not like this, but me and Zach was just like, yeah, let's shit on someone's head, whatever. And then Zach just came back into the room. We're all chilling on the pregame. We're just drinking. Mm. And Zach comes in and he's got a milk carton full of piss. And we're like, ugh. And he went, look at that. Look how dark it is. And he was all buzzing with his piss. And we were all like, oh, imagine chucking that at someone. Would you drink that for £1 million? Just like making jokes. And then you said something like, yeah, would you drink that for this much? Would you pour
40
it over?
£40 it was.
Pour it over your head for this much.
You pour it over your head for £40.
And I went, yeah, I'd do that. £40.
And I was like, thinking you'd say no, I was like, yeah, go on then. And you was like,
yeah, I took yeah, you right happening. Up on that.
100%.
You went, and then all of a sudden, you're like, you sit in these weird fucking robots. You're like, right, here we go.
I've got this video somewhere.
You can't just speak with impunity. You said, would you pour it over your head for 40 quid? I said, yes, let's go. So we did it. We went upstairs and you got this carton of piss. And it was not nice piss. It was not healthy piss.
Warm, frothy, dark
piss. It was
piss.
Terps. It
oh,
was,
it was horrible.
It was Ron Seal.
It was the worst thing.
It was wood stainer. It was dark piss. Hot. Boiling hot. I was like, pour it over my head. Calzonio's going to give me 50 quid. What?
40 quid.
40 quid. I don't want to big myself up. It wasn't even for 50. It was for
it was
less
not.
Than half a
I thought
half
you were
going to
say no, man. I thought you were going to be like, nah, I ain't fucking
yeah.
doing that.
I actually felt bad as it was happening. I was like, I feel like Cal was not serious and I've said it.
I wasn't, man. If you just...
I took
if we'd have went
you.
Out, I'd have been like, you can just, I'll sort you out. Do you want some money? I'll fucking give it you.
Yeah, because
we'll
really,
right.
you didn't want to give any, you were like, ha ha ha, no one's going
to,
but I was like,
about.
I'll take
you didn't
realise money.
It was a real thing.
You know, and all of a sudden, the fucking demon showed up and was like, yeah,
we went up to my bathroom, I stripped off and you poured this piss over my head. And I thought, I've got to give him a show.
He did not mess around. It's not like he went, oh, it's on my back.
Tell him.
It was horrible.
He fucking surprised me.
It was
like,
horrible.
Fucking poured it over his head.
And his pee's going like...
And he started gargling it and fucking rubbing it in his eyes and shit. And you're horrified like...
In for a penny, in for a pound.
And you were like, I'm a horrible person. Me and him were like, this is noble tackle, this.
And that's when I knew you two would be friends for life. Because like, I got scammed by two of the most awful people in the world.
If it makes you feel any better, Cal, I use that money wisely. Like that sort that made me survive for a couple of weeks.
I invested that in my first Canon
yeah,
camera,
you didn't,
and I became Shaolin Pete and made a fucking video.
And that
he
boy
didn't even get around
Richard Branson.
yeah, you created all this.
I didn't know what level you boys would go to, and you fucking had
this. It. All came from your bladder.
It could have been really because
I'm disappointed.
My mum was trying to kick me out. She was just like, fuck off, if you're not going to get a real job, out you go. No offense.
If you're not going to get a real job, fuck off. Hey, mum, I let Cal piss on me for 40 quid. Shine, you can stay here another week.
It's 40 quid.
Fuck off. I got
what do you
40...
mean, Cal piss on that? It was fucking
40 dabs, lad. Fuck off, United.
No offence to Alison, but like I completely understand.
Hang on a minute,
it was
like I had no fucking piss. One of your piss. Your piss.
It was my piss.
It was probably Zach's piss. Yeah, it wasn't your piss. But honestly, my
no. Mom, this was the first time like meeting fucking you properly.
Really?
A fucking conversation. No. Like we'd had a bit of a laugh, and I thought he was always pissing about. I don't think he was dark as he was.
He definitely did piss about.
It goes beyond that.
And then I was like. Oh shit, this man's a demon.
But in truth, you facilitated me continuing on the path I was on, which was creative, because I put that probably into music videos. I didn't have to move out and start stacking shelves at Aldi.
Fuck off. You put your fucking lime chiggers pockets with that for a week.
Chigger is the guy that runs the chippy near mine that used to buy chicken and chip balms. Chips and curry for breakfast every day. Months, years. To this day! Yo, let's wrap it up.
Can I be honest, man? Like, I give you that money, not because you won the bet, because I felt sorry.
I think you were going to give it to me either way, and I appreciate it.
Yeah, no.
I
felt bad. That's why I had
it. And I needed it. That was
a lot
of money to me.
You know, like, you see that crackhead with, like, no legs? And you just,
that one at Tesco's.
Yeah, and you're just like, fucking hell. That's how I felt that day.
Yeah, and that was me. That's been me. And I'm so close to being that again. Like, there's one minor mishap going to happen in my life, and I'm back there again. And I'll be sucking dick for rock.
I didn't respect you for so long, man. It's unreal.
Yeah, it's fair. It's completely justified. Shall we wrap this up, though?
I mean, if you got anything. Zach, have you got any more crazy stories to say?
I got loads, but...
Well, let's keep going then. Fuck it.
Come on, kid.
Right. It's another fucked up child story, right?
Of course it is.
Get us. Tell them.
Right. My dad used to smoke a lot of crack. And heroin.
No.
No. Hey. This is mad bananas. And this is true, right? I defy him to lie and say it's... Don't believe me, I'm a true liar.
Goodbye to everyone who trusted me.
That's a different video, boys.
Oh, yeah, you're on about, I am a true liar.
I am a kid's Dude. Lover.
Shall we put that on?
Oh, shit. It's my life, whatever I wanna do.
It's my life. It's my life. It's my life.
Show me the video as well.
Yeah.
But do you not care what people think about you? No. Hit him with it. Holy.
Secret banger. People who've not heard this need to hear it.
They do. No, I am very sentimental. No. People say I am a waste fellow. He does not know the taste of his fellow.
Sure. Right. Lyrics that change the world.
Mate, the producer on this track is buzzing for it. Shaolin Pete 2001.
Hey, what the hell do you think of yourself?
Is he wearing underpants on his head? Good, bad, I always thought bad in good. I am a very good bad boy.
I think that is actually underpants on his head, man. That's not a...
I am a very good bad boy. I am a very good bad boy. I am a daydreamer. I am a night worker. I am a risk taker. I am a self famer. I am a brain eater. I am a heart beater. I am a mind reader. I am a truth finder. I am a smart cheater. I am a fan killer. I am a I am a kid's lover. That's what he says. I am a kid's lover is what
Fuck you now, man.
Okay. So what do you wanna become to everyone?
Just leave everyone. Leave everyone.
Dirty hands. Na. Where's his nappy gone on his head? Wait for the end. He spit some knowledge right now.
Is he about to do a little freestyle verse?
Don't believe me, I am a true liar.
Don't believe me, I am a true liar.
Don't believe me, I am a true liar.
Is that the end as well?
Every time I show Alex out, she pisses herself.
But yeah, you were on about, you were saying you're a true liar.
Don't
tell
me.
The story, man. Go.
Right.
Nah, go on, tell the story, man.
I don't know how old I am. It's pre high school. It's primary school. Probably about 8 or 9.
Right. if there's grass on the pitch, play ball.
And I'm sat in this fucking car with my dad on a car park, a busy car park, a retail car park. And he's like, listen, cock. And for anyone who's listening, cock is like a northern term of endearment. Is that a correct way to put it?
Yeah.
It's like, he isn't speaking to his penis.
He's not saying, all right, penis. He's saying, like, cock is like saying love. So someone's like, yeah, all right, cock. And he was like, listen, cock, keep an eye out for us. Make sure no one's walking by. So I'm playing lookout in my dad's car, right, while he's chasing the dragon in the fucking driver's seat, smoking some heroin on the foils. Right. Meanwhile, fucking windows are up and I'm choking on this heroin smoke. I'm like, this is too much for my little 8-year-old lungs. What is going on? I don't want to be in this situation. And I'm, and at the same time, I'm anxious because I'm like, I hope no one can see what's happening because this is bad. So I'm looking around being a little guard for him. And I'm thinking, it's too much this ride. So I start trying to wind the window down on the car because I'm like, I need some fresh air, right? I need fresh air. And I open the window, he goes, roll the window back up, cock. You're letting hot flavour out.
That was bad.
Those were his exact words. Roll window up, cock. You're letting flavour out. The flavour of the... This motherfucker making an egg, making fucking Sunday roast. Chasing that sweet Caroline. That fucking tooting car moon just like... Mate, it will never leave me, that image.
Don't let the flavour out.
Mate, I legit seen that guy sniffing a bag of glue, huffing the fuck out of it, throwing up in that bag and still huffing it. With not a penny to put in the electric meter.
Like, he's fucking huffing a bag of fucking sick.
Huffing a bag of sick and glue. He's it's like, bad. I'm like, here, Dad, I can hear my mum. He's like, basically two eyes. He's like, you got to go down and open the door, cock.
He said, hey, Dad, what have you got on you there? He said,
9 grams of heroin, 100 grams of coke, 12 rolls of mushrooms, 2 pounds of smoke, 3 gallons of dust juice, and a tank of LSD, and 1,000 pills of every kind of ecstasy. Has hashish, I bought a 62 when I was younger with my crew. I had them niggas sniffing glue. It's 40 shit
of... Yeah, man. Shit, Dad, but I tell you what, I give him that. He can fucking take some drugs, that cunt. Honestly, I've seen some...
That's amazing.
Some
man.
Great skills in drug taking.
That's amazing.
Shit that would kill a fucking horse.
Nah, man, like, you're gonna hotbox a car with fucking heroin.
Don't you, let the flip.
And your kid's like fucking trying to get it's out, and you're bad. Like, don't let the flip.
We're laughing,
out,
but that
up.
Is, it's child abuse.
It child sort abuse. Of is, and it's definitely not shaped me into the fucking emotionally unstable adult I am today. But.
Fuck off.
It honestly, man, 1,000,001 stories like that. Even worse than that.
We'll have to leave until next time, kid. Let's wrap it up.
Let me get a fresh one.
Thanks a lot for watching. It's been a ropey one.
I honestly, I swear to God, every time I come on this, I'm kind of like, and you know what? It always turns out pretty good. I'm not like fucking being like, ooh, look at me. But like, look at me. But like, it always turns out pretty good, and it's probably down to like how he edits it and whatnot. But, and I'm always a little bit doubtful, but this time I'm like, I cannot imagine how you could salvage any of this bullshit.
This episode's half an hour, right?
If you're watching this and you're thinking, this is hilarious, or I've been entertained by this, then you fucking need psychological evaluation.
Don't target the audience, mate. No.
Because I swear to fucking
God. There's a million reasons.
You're tapped.
No.
This is bananas as fucking...
It's fun.
No, it's not.
There's a morbid curiosity. It's interesting.
But it's barely been coherent. Like, it's the fucking set of dickheads just going, it's funny for us because we're fucking off our box. What is this? What is life?
What is going on, Peter?
What is...
I'm very grateful that you guys...
what a magnet.
...joined me.
Pretty good, aren't they, man?
I love you both. I wanted to make these final three episodes bangers, and that's exactly why I made sure that you were involved with it.
Thank you.
Appreciate that.
Viewers, thanks very much for checking it out. I took a little time off, and we were back with this... If you're watching this far, then you enjoyed it, didn't you? And got a good one coming up soon. Jimmy Chirpsall.
Who?
Ninja Warrior.
Oh,
James Birchall. You know the guy. We're about to wrap it all up forever. We'll be done. And I was very thrilled to have you both on one of the denouement.
It is not even the beginning of the night.